Robert Nkerewe, the deputy head teacher of the host school, Jinja College, welcomed participants and organizers of the debate to his school.
I want to appreciate new vision for choosing Jinja College as the host school to host this very important debate about climate change. Dear organizers of this debate, I want again to appreciate you that as we take on this very important debate, the learners and all the people who are going to get involved in this debate are going to get aware of the different negative impacts of environmental degradation.
Nkerewe added that engaging these youth in climate change issues is the best way to ensure sustainability in the fight against this global phenomenon.
There are things that we've been looking at in our schools and we've been just taking them for granted. But from this debate, you are going really to know that these have impacted greatly on our environment. And also leaving that aside, we're also going to get exposed as participants that the confidence is also going to be built within this debate because there will be cross-examination and even that element of critical thinking is also going to be developed because within a debate, you need to think very fast and then make responses.
New Vision is implementing the Green School Climate Change Project in 100 secondary schools in Uganda in partnership with the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations with funding from Swedish Embassy. New Vision editor John Eremo, who is also the Green Schools Project Manager, congratulated the team for the step made in the right direction on the journey to fight climate change and mitigate its effects.
I would like to congratulate all of you for making it thus far. When we started in October last year, we didn't know whether the response would be as expected, but we were actually overwhelmed. And you are very lucky, the 10 schools from Busoga region that are participating in this project. The regional debate is one of the key activities on our calendar.
Those big schools, there are some schools which can win them, depending on the content of the students. The people that are competing with us, I'm telling them that we are also prepared so that we are going to have a very competitive debate.
We have the gut to win this debate because I think we are at home. We have made enough research. We are going to incur many things that maybe we have incurred such resolutions before, themes of climate change. So that makes me feel like we have to win tonight's debate. No, we are not. We are never shaken because actually it's not the first time we are debating.
Come here for the debate concerning climate change and the innovations that work. I've come with all the content concerning climate change and I'm sure I'm going to win.
There are 100 schools competing for the Green Schools Project Prize from 10 regions of Uganda. The three top schools from each of the 10 regions will participate in the National Climate Change Tournament scheduled for September in Kampala, where the project winner is to be announced.
It is one of those key activities that will be contributing towards your schools winning the Grand Climate Change Prize. That is going to be a project that your schools will choose. It is competitive, so we are all, I'm sure all your schools are counting on you here present today.
Report by Rogers Akanoijuka and Jonathan Mitala for the news.